Hey everybody, this is Perch, and hopefully I don't want to do videos about this every day, but it has getting picked up, has getting picked up, is getting picked up all over the place. And so this Image Comics union, the last 24 hours, a lot has kind of started to clarify. Now, when I first talked about this story yesterday, I mentioned that it was my belief, my speculation was that Eric Stevenson, some of the other management at Image, knew this was coming, that there was at least some word given, some notice that they were aware on some level, because the way it was rolled out, i.e. via Twitter thread and then website, which, by the way, I understand different generations do different things. I understand that these tools are omnipresent everywhere and everything else. But I think if you're going to create a major stance on something, rolling it out via Twitter thread feels like you're, I don't know, just from a messaging standpoint, it feels like you are just setting yourself up for problems. That's how it feels to me. But I don't know. I mean, maybe that's how people want to organize their business now. I just, given that you don't control the message, people can just reply, retweet, and just it can turn into a spidery mess. The reason why you'd go to Twitter to do this kind of thing is to make some noise, to put some pressure, to make some attention, not to kind of form a labor union. But anyway, as time has rolled by, as I've talked to more people, I've talked to a couple of people who are, I'd say, tangentially involved. There's some people who are with the company who were kind of aware this was going on, but wasn't aware of how it was going to roll out, aren't some of the main people who are in this. It appears now that at least management was not given a heads up, or at least this wasn't something that was discussed and announced ahead of time, but rather a bit of a surprise. And when I say surprise, I don't know. Again, I'm speculating here, but it sounds like somebody may have given him the word on like a Sunday evening before it rolled Monday morning. That's at least how it appears to now be. The story has been picked up by all the typical comic channels. You've got your Newsarama, your CBR, your Bleeding Cool, your AV Club, your IGN, your comicbook.com, your Games Radar. Well, Games Radar is news. By the way, this comic book worker union, why is it a target? Now, I'm not asking this question like, duh. It's a weird logo. When you have this this backdrop of targeting the comic industry and particularly of their demands, you know, one of them drew a bunch of attention, and that was we're going to, you know, basically gatekeep different creators who are this or that. And so you make your logo into a target, like a bullseye. Who's in charge of branding here? I mean, come on. I don't know. Anyway, that's just very, very strange choice. So anyway, Vice has now picked it up, and more are picking up. Now, Vice is, Vice has other comic stories like It's Impossible to Make Money for Most Writers and Artists in Comics, Batman and the FaZe Clan Team Up for Crossover Nobody Asked For, and Batman Doesn't Eat Pussy, DC says. So, Vice has a long history of comic articles here. But anyway, so this article from Vice really doesn't, put a lot into it. But there has been at least a statement from Image. And that was what a lot of people were waiting for, is what is Image going to say about all this? So Image basically responds with a sentence, and that statement is, Image has always believed in the fair and equitable treatment of staff and has always strived to support employees to the best of our company's ability with regard to their employment. That's it. So what do we read into that statement? The demand from the Comic Book Worker Union was that they be recognized. That is not what has been gotten here. That's definitely not what that sentence does. The sentence basically states that, in many ways, there's no need for a union because we treat our people well and we strive to support our employees and we have fair and equitable treatment. So what is this union stuff is what that sentence basically reads. But if you play this thing out, Image is in a bit of a bind at this point, because by the way that this all rolled, and when we're talking actual numbers, the people who signed their names to it, I think it's nine. It sounds like there's maybe a dozen of people more or less involved. There's some other people kind of around the periphery of Image that are a little confused and waiting to see how this rolls out. There were people, I mean, one of the things that I find a little ironic and was a conversation I had yesterday with somebody at Image was this whole thing is about providing, you know, representation and communication and you know, transparent company culture. And yet several people at Image were surprised by this, not the management, but the workers. So this number two goal of a creation of a more transparent company culture was apparently this was put out by a, you know, a group of people who didn't communicate with other people in the company. So, I mean, that's kind of lousy. But the snowball effect of what happened was this statement goes out. It gets repeated immediately by Bleeding Cool, which indicated that the people involved were at least making Bleeding Cool aware, perhaps faster than the actual Image Comics management. And then it goes to Twitter, where it gets signal boosted by a number of influencers and very quickly gets thousands of likes and retweets and a bunch of very deep, you know, full-throated, enthusiastic support from a lot of people within comics. All of this happened relatively quickly. Within about 4 hours, it had been rolling pretty strong. Now, what's interesting about this is if management was not aware this was going on, it will feel a lot to them like a bit of, I don't know, sabotage is the wrong word, but certainly feel like it's going to feel like dirty games. It's going to feel like the people are trying to force their hand into something, which in fairness is sometimes what unions do. And I don't mean that as a good or a bad statement. It's just if there's a really bad problem with management, if people are really trying to get something accomplished, one of the ways they do it is by not giving notice and by trying to get a huge groundswell of popular support before they actually, you know, before they talk to management. So it forces management hand. It makes it harder for them to negotiate. And that's kind of what happened here. So now at this point, if, you know, Eric Stevens says, no, we're not going to recognize this union. This was, you know, 10 people who are doing this and some of their demands, like we talked about yesterday, are frankly impossible. Some of these would be very hard to accomplish just logistically, you know, in terms of kind of money that you need in order to pull this off, that money the company doesn't have. And we'll get more to that in a second. But the other parts, I mean, there's things here which are making some, again, they're called goals more than demands, but these goals, some of them are just not legally sound. And not including that last one, but it's goals need to be SMART. Have you ever heard that word? If you've worked in a company, you've heard about SMART goals. That's I'm going to forget what SMART stands for, but it's actionable is the A in SMART. Measurable is the M. SMART, measurable, actionable, something. Anyway, it's the measurable and the actionable that kind of play into here, because several of these goals are not measurable or actionable. They're difficult. So whoever wrote this is just a nice statement of wishes, but it would be very hard for a company to actually adopt it. And that's the challenge. And then, yeah, you do get to that last one, which is this a collective voting option, which we talked about yesterday, to immediately cancel publication of Title Who Created. A lot of people are zeroing in on that because it feels like a gatekeeping, which it is. And it also feels like something that could be abused, which it would be. And but more importantly, it basically takes the selection and management of titles in the Image portfolio and hands them over to a collective group for voting. And this would be a massive shift to Image. What's curious about this whole thing, which very few people are pointing out, is that in the statement, it said, this should not be radical or revolutionary. It is, in fact, a natural development for a company to start the way Image did. In the early stages of organizing, we look to Image founders for inspiration. Except this goal of having a full-time employee, basically the editors, picking and choosing who gets to be, who gets work and who gets canceled, is kind of the exact opposite of what Image went for. Image wanted to break away from corporate control. This statement is putting control back in the corporation, in fact, at a greater amount. It's basically making the voting of who stays and who goes this kind of crowdsourced activity to all the employees. It's the exact 180-degree opposite of Image, of what Image was founded for. The original goal of Image was that creators would be able to bring their works and, you know, put them out and you know, it basically live or die by what their ideas. And here it's saying, regardless of the creator's ideas, we're going to vote on whether they exist or not. Now the tricky part is, you know, if a creator or somebody working from the comics is actually engaging in sexual assault, then yeah, you wouldn't want to work with that person. The problem is, they're going to enforce this through a collective voting option of the people that takes away things like burden of proof and that it makes it very, very difficult. What if, for example, a creator comes in, they're accused of racism, their title is canceled, it later comes out that the person lied about it, that creator is now going to sue Image into oblivion by the nature of these rules. This is not a good plan financially, legally. It's just not a good plan. So, I mean, that's where all this gets to. And then again, where's the money coming from? Well, at least from hearing from one person, the belief is that the money is going to come from looking at some of the bigger contracts and maybe, you know, making some demands to renegotiate them so that the contracts, the money flows other places. That was on a few people's minds yesterday from within Image. And maybe that's part of this plan, because it would need to be funded. And if that's the case, then a number of creators who had these deals, again, correctly could, you know, either sue or take their work elsewhere. Instead of getting, you know, more money for the collective here, they would have, you know, less money because these titles, there's plenty of competition. A lot of these creators that have these deals could take them down the street to Boom or to anyone. They could take it to Dynamite and get some of these things going. And, you know, then you're winding up with nothing. So there's some real logistical problems here. But anyway, that was Image's response. Image has always believed in the fair and equitable treatment of staff and has always strived to support employees to the best of our company's ability with regard to the employment. Nothing further at the moment. Again, this story is getting picked up more and more places. It's being gleefully spread around to, I think, force Image's hand. Like I said, they're in a tough spot now, because if they reject it completely, they're anti-worker, and that's going to just have people crapping on them for, you know, for months. But if they go forward with this, I think they've got themselves into kind of legal and financial entanglements that are going to be very tough for them to unwind. So stay tuned. Let's see if some days can go by and we can talk about some other things. I will not be playing that theme song every video, but you guys got to chill out, because the more you do it, the more I'm going to play it. I'm just putting that out. I, you know, sorry. I'm a dick that way. There you have it. Form a union and get that theme song changed. Thanks for listening.